Social Media 101,
a training series for today's insurance agents.
In this episode, we are talking Facebook for Business, what that means for you, and how to get started. SMT Episode 14, Creating a Facebook Page. People use Facebook to connect with friends and family. Their first thought is not usually to connect with businesses and brands. However, marketing on Facebook is still a lucrative tool for people trying to grow awareness and talk to their target audience. That's why Facebook created the business page. This type of page allows businesses to run marketing efforts through something other than a personal profile. And nowadays, Facebook will delete a personal profile that's not actually a person, and we do not want to see that happen to you. Facebook designed this business page to give you some business-specific perks. For instance, your page is public, so everyone can see it. You don't have a limit on how many followers you can have, and you can include links, surveys, and call-to-action buttons on your profile. Best of all, it's free, it's easy, and it's one of the most intuitive ways to put your business on social media. We created a guide to help you go through the process of creating a page. We take you through it step by step. When you're finished listening to this episode, head on over to our show notes. We'll have the link to our guide there so you can easily download that and get started on your Facebook business page. Now, let's talk profile. Your profile is your personal landing page made up of several customizable sections, including your cover image, the About tab, and Call to Action button. Together, these features create a snapshot of your business and accent the posts, videos, and photos you've added to your page. You want to make sure your page is as fine-tuned as possible so that when people land there, they want to take action. Here are the spaces to update first. If you haven't already, add a profile picture. We've mentioned in previous episodes that if you choose to use a picture of yourself, it should be as professional as possible. That brings us to your cover photo. Your cover image stretches across the top of your profile. This is prime above-the-fold real estate for you to use. Whichever image you choose, make sure that it's sized to 851 by 315 pixels and will make a positive impact. And don't worry if you didn't get those dimensions, they are included in the guide. One last tip, consider switching your cover image every so often to keep your profile fresh, especially if you're using it to advertise promotions or seasonal campaigns. The About tab. When you created your page, you should have submitted a short summary about your business, your address, website, and phone number. Now, you need to add in the rest of those details. Through your About tab, you can add information like your hours of business, whether you have a storefront, and so on. Make sure this has as much information as you want to provide to your clients. With more and more people using Facebook like a search engine, it's important to have your business information out there. Lastly, but most importantly, add a call to action button. Right under your cover photo is the place to add a button. It's the blue button with a plus sign that says add a button. This button is known as a call to action or CTA button, and it's the call to action on your page, also known as the next step you want someone who is interested in your services to take. It can be a phone number, which is useful for mobile viewers, a website, a form, or a message. Be sure to add something so that when someone wants to take the next step with your business, they can. Give it a try this week. Download the guide and use it to create your very own Facebook page. Then, update your page with a cover photo, all your business information, and a call to action button. And don't forget to spread the news to your clients that your page is live and in need of